Hello everybody! If you clicked in this video, it's probably because you're very annoyed by the fact that anytime you color grade in Premiere Pro, your exported version of the video never looked the same contrasty or saturated as the one that was in your Premiere Pro player. And this is a well-documented problem. This is not just your computer that's doing something wrong. It happens to everybody, especially for Apple users. If you are color grading, you know, using a MacBook Pro or an iMac, this problem is pretty significant. And this video provides a fix to this problem for those Apple users. So if you're a PC users, I'm sorry, I don't quite have a solution for you, but if you're a Mac user, you definitely wanna check this out. So in the past years, I've seen other YouTubers coming up with their own solutions. I'm referring to some videos that I've seen recently by Matt Johnson or Matti Haapoja. And they pretty much were sharing with you guys a LUT provided by Adobe that was supposed to compensate for the color shift that happens between the Premiere Pro player and the exported version. However, the LUT that these guys provided through Adobe never really worked for me. You know, I would get images that were much darker than what I used to see in my Premiere Pro player, and the two images didn't match. So for me, that method never worked out well. So therefore, I started to research my own way on how to match as close as possible my export to what I saw in the Premiere Pro preview player. So I'm not gonna dive too much into the reason why this happens. All you need to know is that unfortunately Premiere Pro works at a different color space than QuickTime and YouTube. Therefore, anything you're seeing in Premiere Pro is never gonna translate identically to QuickTime and YouTube. So that's why, you know, you see this color difference. And you know, after some testing, I finally came up with a LUT myself that I designed in DaVinci Resolve that, contrary to Premiere Pro, have the ability to change, you know, the timeline color spaces. And I pretty much calculated in this LUT the difference that happens in between, you know, your exported version in Premiere Pro and what you see in your Premiere Pro player. So therefore, I think my solution works a little bit better than those other solutions that, you know, I saw in other YouTube videos. I would love you to try it and let me know if this works a little bit better for you. So all you have to do to get started with this LUT that I'm telling you about is you have to go in my description, click the link below, download the LUT, then open the timeline you're working on that you want to export, and make sure that you create an adjustment layer that it sits on top of everything in your timeline. And then thanks to Lumetri, you're gonna add in the creative tab the LUT that I gave you, leave the intensity at 100%. You're gonna notice that the footage is gonna get suddenly a little bit more extra saturated and slightly darker, but that's okay because that's the extra saturation and contrast that we're giving to the image to make sure that it matches our player. And then you export, and technically now the exported version should match the one you had in your Premiere Pro player. Lots of people sometimes ask me for tips and tricks about color grading, and one of the most crucial ones is to make sure, of course, that whatever you're exporting looks like what you've been working on. So, you know, getting started with this LUT is gonna be a game changer for you, I hope. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope this video is serving you well, and if this LUT has fixed your solution on the saturated colors in Premiere Pro and you feel like giving back, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment, because this helps a lot the channel to grow. And plus, I guess you might want to stick around for the next tip and tricks I'm gonna drop in this channel. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.